No more Kim Jong-un. Trump just took action after imminent attack plan on US leaked overnight. North Korean dictator Kim Jong-un entered into dangerous territory with the US when they vowed to attack the tiny US territory of Guam. On Tuesday, President Donald Trump warned they would be met with fire and fury if they escalated their threat to action. North Korea didn't take Trump seriously and are now going to feel the full wrath of what our president promised after Kim's imminent plan on attack leaked out last night and details exactly where and who he will hit with his missiles he's already moved into place to launch. Regardless of how ridiculous Kim Jong-un and his archaic military is, Trump understands what his predecessor refused to acknowledge. This problem child isn't going away and is genuinely insane enough to push the button as we're seeing now. This isn't a war of words, it's a provocation of actual war, and what Kim is planning to do by mid-August is his boldest and most destructive yet. The regime's recent testing of intercontinental ballistic missiles is in clear violation of the United Nations as well as international laws. That hasn't stopped Kim from launching one into the waters of Japan, but his reign of terror and defiance didn't stop there. PBS reports. The people of Guam woke up Thursday to another pointed threat from Pyongyang, which vowed to complete a plan to attack waters near the island by mid-August, adding a timeline to a threat from a day earlier that North Korea would create an enveloping fire around Guam. Like other U.S. territories, Guam has a sometimes complicated relationship with the U.S. mainland, but many across the island say despite the threats and concerns they feel reassured and protected by the military, especially in times of tense geopolitical sparring. The plan of attack details that there will be four missiles launched near the U.S. Pacific territory of Guam and could hit our military vessels parked outside the island to protect it. Although the 160,000 citizens living on the small island are waking up in fear this morning, they are reassured by America's military presence that Trump has moved into place since talk of an attack on Guam began. He's not sitting back and waiting to see if Kim is serious, he's putting people in place now to protect the people in Guam. About 160,000 people live on the island, which extends about 12 miles, 19.31 kilometers. At its widest. The American military presence on Guam consists of two bases, Anderson Air Force Base in the north and Naval Base Guam in the south, which are home to 7,000 U.S. troops, according to PBS. I feel that the presence of the military on Guam will help us a lot, said Virgie Matson, 51, a resident of Dadao, Guam's most populated village. They are here to protect the islands, just in case something happens. Reuters reports. North Korea dismissed warnings by U.S. President Donald Trump that it would face fire and fury if it threatened the United States and outlined detailed plans on Thursday for a missile strike near the U.S. Pacific territory of Guam. Experts in South Korea said the plans unveiled by the reclusive North ratcheted up risks significantly since Washington was likely to view any missile aimed at its territory as a provocation, even if launched as a test. North Korea's apparently rapid progress in developing nuclear weapons and missiles capable of reaching the U.S. mainland has fueled tensions that erupted into a war of words between Washington and Pyongyang this week, unnerving regional powers and global investors. North Korea is insistent on attacking Guam since it's a crucial, strategic hub for U.S. forces in the Pacific and the closest they can get to impact America with what they have. While the left is incessantly critical of how the president is handling Kim Jong-un, blaming Trump for bringing America on the brink of war, they ignore that their beloved leader did nothing to stop North Korea in his 8 years in office, which have brought us to this point today. Obama dropped the ball on almost everything and handed Trump his massive mess. He is now doing what he can to disarm North Korea. One thing is for certain, that there's a new commander-in-chief in charge now who doesn't act like this isn't happening and believes in taking a proactive approach to the problem rather than a reactive one.